Hey guys, this is Basinger 3 and 3 with a continuation of the Super Mario Odyssey Let's Play. This time it's gonna be slightly different, as I don't think if you can tell right now though, but this is actually post-commentary. I'm not actually playing this live or anything. I actually recorded most of the footage of me trying to gather through the moons as much as possible, and decided to just co-commentate through this to see if that format works. Mostly because I feel like I won't really provide enough commentary, or I'll be like mostly silent anyways whenever I'm trying to gather the majority of the moons that are available for the game. So that's why I feel I'm gonna try and do like the Super Gaming Brothers method by doing a post-commentary whenever I'm doing more of the collectible things. If you look at Super Gaming Brothers Let's Play of Super Mario Sunshine when they were collecting the blue coins, well, first off, I'm not drunk right now, so I don't think that's going to be much of an issue or anything, but, right now I'm just basically, I'll talk my experience. For first one, there's every single world has a Koopa free running, level, where you get to get one moon, two moons if you manage to, complete the golden challenge, which is, a golden Koopa, which is more faster. I'm not sure if I'm going to be showcasing all of that or not, though, but, I think, yeah, that's basically, like, there. That's a moon you can collect, and those are one of the easiest moons you could probably get if you're a skilled enough player, I want to say. That's our first moon in our post-commentary. So yeah, I've edited so that I skipped some parts as well, because the majority of the footage of me trying to gather all the moons as possible... Oh yeah, there's this moon where, like... By the way, buying one of those moons is mandatory in order for 100% completion. You don't necessarily need to buy, like, 10 moons or to cover the cost or anything, but, like, you definitely need to buy at least one of them per store in order to gain the completion. There's also rocks as well. If you see a rock that's glowing, most likely there's going to be a moon there. Just try and break it as much as possible. It may take some time though, but eventually it'll work. So as you can tell here that it's taking a while for me to like break the rock. Even the chain shop didn't seem to help at all. it just takes a while. Like, these are one of the most annoying moons, I will have to say. It's not the absolutely annoying one, we'll get to that when we get to that, but it's certainly one of those moves that's very misleading. It's like, yeah, it takes so much hits to break through the rock just for this one moon. It's like, I hope that, like, if there's, like, a feature patch, or maybe they already did patch it, I don't know, but, like, if there's, like, a feature patch, they could probably, like, make it so that there's less likely to you do more damage on the rocks or something like that, so that it's a lot more easier and a lot less cumbersome to break through the rocks just to get one single moon. But yeah, you saw me previously right there trying to enter through a, I guess one of those, like, a door things. I think during the Let's Play I did actually collect one moon, however, the majority of the moons present in almost every single doorway has at least two moons there. That's something I need to mention, without a doubt, is that there's two moons every single doorway. I don't think it's every single doorway or even every single warp pipe, but it's certainly like in the majority. So, so definitely like keep in mind of that when you're trying to collect through as much as possible. So yeah, I think it's like one of these. Oops, sorry, I accidentally hit the microphone for a little bit. Yeah, it was definitely hidden behind one of the rocks. That's about it. I thought I had to collect and destroy every single rock. That's not the case. It's just hidden inside one of the rocks, and well, there it is. Yippity-doo-da! So yeah, bear in mind, I have to collect a total of 999 of these. And the process of doing that was really annoying, though it's a lot more fun if you manage to, like, find them as much as possible. That's also another thing I'm also covering, is that I'm gonna try my best to showcase as many purple coins as possible. There's a little bit of a weird clip-in or a pop-in thing there. Don't mind about that. I think that's just the Switch's hardware or something. So there are four coins that I've missed out on this area alone, but I think I did collect every single moon there, so nothing to worry about there. So yeah, this big rock crater thing that appears in every single level. Once you beat the game, you get the moon rocks start to glow, and once you hit them, you have even more rocks to... sorry, you have even more moons to collect. So, it becomes like this... basically a huge collect-a-thon to get as many moons as possible, or to catch all the moons if possible. I will say straight off the bat that I, the majority of the times, while I did resort to getting the moons by myself, there were some moments in which I did have to take a walkthrough. I think all of the moons in which I got from breaking the moon rock. Okay, there was a fail there for a second. I'll get that moon eventually. And okay, oh, okay, yeah, there we go. You got it. Treasure cliff under the cliff. A treasure under the cliff. So yeah, now there's a lot more moons that showcase when you break through the moon rock. I'm not sure if that's exactly what they call, but I just like to call it moon rock because you beat them after you complete the moon dungeon. But yeah. That's basically it, right? That I need to pretty much say. I kind of lost my train of thought a little bit. I could have sworn I tried to say something. But I'm trying to remember exactly what I said. Hopefully my microphone quality is better. Because right now I'm actually recording off Audacity, which is not my normal method. But it's necessary and required for me to do that because I'm actually doing a video playback rather than, playing the game at the same time. So it's most likely just me trying to look through my gameplay footage, which I haven't looked at in a while. Like, I recorded this back in November 27th, I want to say. I don't remember exactly the date, but it's around that area. By the time I'm recording my commentary right now, it's actually July 6th. And I believe that's when part 20 of Super Mario Odyssey basically plays through. So I'm doing this basically literally all day, by the way. So, yeah. It is July 6th by the time I'm recording this, and for the rest of the partial commentary part as well, there's another fail that I failed at. Yeah, I tried to make it so that I don't showcase everything, just only the necessary bits of what I did. Like, and I like to include some fail compilations from time to time, just so that things mix up a little bit. So it's not like I'm completely perfect or anything. You can tell that I definitely have some flaws within my playstyle. I think originally playing through Super Mario Odyssey, I didn't really know about the throw the Cappy and then dive method to jump on Cappy. I only learned that after watching an any percent speedrun on Super Mario Odyssey, which there are plenty of, by the way. Like, as soon as like this game came out, there's like a shit ton. And if I'm proficient enough, I really want to get into it. Though right now, I have no plans on speedrunning, but if there's any high demand and if I really, really am good at this, I'll try to do like a personal best speedrun of this game. I've been always wanting to get speedrun for a while now. The only issue I have is, of course, my playstyle. But if I just do like a personal best speedrun, then I don't think that's really going to be an issue. I might suck at it, and I think it might be like not a viable gameplay, but it's mainly just for being personal best. It's not necessarily trying to be like the best ever. So I don't mind having the title of what I think would be the best for me. Oh, it's November 18th. It says in the bottom corner, right at the bottom of the text right there. So November 18th is when I recorded most of these. And it's not just all day, by the way. I did cut off some sections, as you can tell from certain moons, which we'll get to later on. So yeah, each date should indicate what's the date in which I got those moon. This one's a relatively easy puzzle, just throw the cap into the mysterious hats. And wow, the text is really like blending in with the thing right there. Yeah, that one was a little bit hard. I just destroyed every single fossil I can, and that's how I got that moon. Yay. There's the bunny as well. Bunnies are usually like really annoying to get. You just have to chase them down. I think they were also equally as annoying as Super Mario 64 as well. But whatever, you get a free star, or in this case a free moon for doing so. You gotta have like one of those like nostalgic throwbacks from the Super Mario series, I guess. Am I doing the golden version again? Yeah, I'm doing the golden version again. It's basically the same thing as what I did. Maybe I did it a little bit faster. But overall, as long as you beat the Golden Koopa twice, then, well, not twice. The Golden Koopa only appears when you break the Moon Rock. But yeah, Koopa free running essentially gives you 2 moons for play session. Yeah, I've been practicing mostly on the Koopa free run, and if you guys are any of my friends on my Nintendo Switch account right now, I think you could just. I think you could see what my best time is. This is not exactly what my best time is right now, by the way. There's a lot more room for improvement, without a doubt. But, I could try and, showcase my personal best time in another video. That'd be nice, I guess. But I don't know if necessarily that's an entertaining thing to see. Because there are a lot of people that are better than me, I will say that without a doubt, especially a lot of speedrunners who could basically play this for a living. But yeah, all these Koopa free-running things are very fun. They remind me so much similar to Koop the Quick in the N64 game. And that's always nice to have. I'm not sure exactly why I asked for the dinosaur. I think I needed him so that he gets out of the way, but there was a shiny thing on the ground, I went after it. I think this T-Rex this time is actually needed. Maybe. I don't know. There might have been like a rock that was blocking the pathway of something. Oh yeah, something I didn't notice, that there was actually an electric thing there. Okay, so yeah, I think I broke the electric wooden pile, the wooden pole, in order to uncover, yeah, under the old electric pole, there to go. In order to unlock that. Also unlock shiny thing. Yeah, so yeah, anything that's shiny, just go after it. Sometimes they give you a coin though, sometimes they give you a heart, sometimes they're enemies, but most likely or not, it's always gonna be a moon. So if you see something shiny, go after it, try ground pound it, and yeah, you'll either get rewarded or whatever. I always like these warp pipe levels. They kind of remind me of Super Mario Sunshine in a way. Whenever they, you know those, like, levels where, like, you lose blood? It's not exactly like this. In fact, I think there's, like, rarely ever an occurrence in which you lose Cappy. There's only one that sticks out to my mind, and we'll get to that when we get to, I believe, the Lunching Kingdom? Or, not the Fossil Kingdom. It was, Lost Island Kingdom or something. The one before, Metron City. Metron City, sorry. Metro City? I don't know. Is it Metro City or is it New Donk City? Okay. I don't know why I had, like, Final Fight on my mind. Maybe it's because, like, Cody was recently announced for... sorry, not announced, but Cody was recently, a playable character for Street Fighter V. That might be it. So here comes my fail compilation. Although, I think looking back right now, I could probably, like, not worry about the Switch at all. I could probably just, like, jump past that, do a Cappy jump, and then bam. Because right now, I did that, and I screwed myself over by getting stuck in there and dying. But yeah, the actual way to do that is by, like, throwing Cappy into the air, and then bam, you could do that. Although I think my original method where you could just jump and bounce off Cappy could possibly work as well. Or you could get a second player. That probably works better, honestly. So there's a moon for the secrets to flying far away from Fantasy Bridge. So yeah, that's Super Mario Odyssey in a nutshell. He's playing again. If you guys hear ice crackling, it's because I'm drinking ice water. It's a very hot day for the summertime, by the way. So, but yeah, it's pretty much a straightforward obstacle course right here. And there's the moon. Yeah, is this what light? What it sounds like for to be a backseat gamer in SGDQ or AGDQ? I get the feeling that might be it because like it's a lot easier to do like couch commentary than to actually play. It requires a lot of mental challenge in order to properly commentate and play the game at the same time. Kind of like stand-up comedy in a way, except keeping the flow intact and not having a script. Well, technically, I'm not having a script right now, but yeah. I hope you guys understand my analogy. Oh yeah, this ghost little fucker wants a caveman outfit. That's why I had the caveman outfit like beforehand, is just to prepare that guy. There are also some moons in which you can't get unless you buy certain items in the store. Ooh, there are multiple coins over there. I think I collected all of them, maybe. By now, did I? 50 gold here. Yep, I got all 50 purple coins in the Fossil Kingdom. Or Cascade Kingdom, as a typical term. There's also a painting I've yet to go to, and this straight up spoils Bowser's Castle that I didn't even know until, like, now. It's quite amazing. I'm not sure if it was, like, present during the main playthrough, but now that I found that out, it's like, oh, well, there's a moon. And now we know Bowser's Castle is a bunch of Japanese shit. Oh yeah, another, buddy thing. Just try to get him as much as possible. Him or her, I don't know what it is. I got a Diddy Kong costume. I'm not sure if I need that, though. Got another music note. I also used Jaxi. Jaxi's the only mandatory way in order to do this, because there's no way you could go fast enough to, collect all those music notes. It's very straightforward. Just slow down when needed, and then when you think you've got the right path, just speed it up. Oh, wow, this is on the same day, too. Okay, some more purple coins. There's a total of 100 here, so I don't even know if I collected all of the purple coins. In fact, I think there's, like, I collected every purple coin except for 3. And I don't think you'll get to see that, those last 3 purple coin things until way later. Did I get the moon already? Or did I get the moon rocks already? I might have, because I think this might have been an exclusive challenge for if you already got the moon. This one was tough, by the way. Like, to get one of the moons, you have to get that key, which is way far away from the actual objective. And furthermore, the way you control the rocket thing, the rocket flower, is pretty hard. It's like, it's not as hard as a Jaxi, but it's definitely like hard, especially if you are going in like those like plain areas right there, where every single place is curved. So that could be tough. And yeah, I got the key to get that. Of all the moons, I want to say that probably are the most complicated to get, I think it has to be Sand Kingdom. At least it's one of the most complicated ones. Mostly because of the quantity it has. Like, I believe Sand Kingdom has the most moons out of all the other kingdoms. I could be wrong. You guys could correct me if I'm wrong, by the way. But yeah, I wouldn't necessarily say I had a whole lot of fun trying to get all the moons in the Sand Kingdom at all. Mostly because there's just way too much of it, and that's something I want to touch upon, is that there are definitely a lot of moons, and you're going to have to be very, very dedicated if you want to collect all of them. All 999, which technically there's not even 999 moons in total. You can get most of them just by, like, buying them from a store. Which at the end I actually did have to do, because I think the total moon count you can get without buying the moon more than once is around 800 and something. It was 857? 75? It was something. It was like it was 800 and something without a doubt. And it was impossible to get 999 without rebuying another moon from the store. So I think at one point I had to like continuously buy stores and grind for coins, because I didn't have enough coins at that time, so 1,000 coins equates to 10 moons. I had to do that a lot. I think, I want to say 20 times. In total, I had to spend like 20,000 coins. We'll get to that when we get to that. I'm certainly not going to show it, though, but I will certainly show the method of how I grinded a lot of coins. It was mostly due to a YouTube video that I looked up, where there's this one spot that you get as much coins as possible, as little effort as possible as well. Oh, those things were melted, so I managed to get those purple Doritos. Yeah. The pictures were also very interesting. There are puzzles, without a doubt, that were very hard to do. I don't think I did most of them legitimately, though. Some of them I had to do a walkthrough, some of them I legitimately knew how to do it. And there were some where I knew how to do it, but I got the wrong positioning from, like, a certain area. Like, I was like 1 feet off or something, which was pretty stupid. But yeah, most of the picture moves I think require basically a ground pound. Yeah. Get to a rocket, I believe. Yeah, this is one of the few moons in which you can't use Cappy. Hey Nathan, Rocket League's in Nintendo Switch. I think this was like around the area in which like Rocket League was announced on Nintendo Switch, and people are playing it. Actually, I own two copies on it. One for PC and one for Switch. Mostly so that I could have, like, multiple people playing. Because, or at least one most of my family members playing, because I use my own account, my niece uses my Switch account, and my nephew has his own account on his own PC. So it's basically like a three-way family Rocket League team. Yeah, there were some missing Doritos here too I wanted to get. And there we go, only 40 more to go. This was, like I said, this is very much akin to Super Mario Sunshine and their levels when you lose blood. I think we needed to use Cappies to put on that Scarecrow just for a challenge because there's no platforms or anything. I saw a couple of coins there, I wanted to follow them. And I noticed, like, in a very, very tiny black spot that there was a secret area there. So I went for it, and lo and behold, I am behind the moon thing. I thought I had to actually buy a moon so that disappears or something, but that doesn't seem to be the case at all. One of the another annoying moons to collect was the Lakitu. I'm not sure if I don't get this one right now, but the Lakitus are definitely one of the most annoying moons to try and get. Just because of how, I want to say, imprecise it is. Or how kind of RNG-based it is as well, because there are some shadows in which you think it's the moon, but in actuality it's just a big fish that gives you, like, a lot of money or something. Or a big heart container. I really like these Scarecrow levels, by the way. They definitely put your skills to the test if you don't have Cappy with you, so it makes you a lot more less reliant on Cappy if you want to parkour your way through the area. I think there was like some. Oh, okay, there was a bird there, but like I was mainly talking about those Dorito pieces right there. I'm not sure if I get them or not. For some reason, I don't get them. I think I used the Jaxi to get them, which was a little bit weird because I think that could have just easily jumped over them. I don't know what I was thinking. Maybe I didn't see it at the time or something. I also missed two different Dorito pieces as well, so I'm not sure why, but there's, for any of you guys who want to see where the Dorito pieces are, there they are. Yeah, the Jaxi, the way it controls is very weird. It's very hard to control it, especially because it's going way, way too fast. So you're gonna have to, like, control it properly by utilizing the brake as much as possible. It was horrible trying to control this thing. The only leeway I want to say I had was whenever there's straightaway moments like these. And I failed significantly that time, so I think I'm going to do it again. Alright. Another thing about the break I want to mention is that it's finite. It's not unlimited breaks. It will break off out of a break eventually, leading you defenseless to its speed. There we go, I think I might have put it there. Yeah, it may be fun to be zooming fast as possible, but you gotta be, very careful. Oh wow, I'm having trouble trying to get this moon. Be very careful when you're riding on the Jaxi. Otherwise, you can just careen all the way off to the edge. I'm not sure if I do actually careen off the edge in this level or not. Hopefully I don't, so that I don't have to worry about being a noob or anything, but okay, it looks like I'm safe. Got two. Like I said, whenever there's like a warp pipe area or a secret area that you've found, most likely or not, there is usually two moons, and if not, then Cappy will certainly tell you whether or not there's still a moon left. There's actually two birds, something I didn't notice until now. I said, oh, like, there's another bird. I'm not sure if it was the same bird as the other one, but I tried to just experiment again, and bam, right there. Oh, this is one of the another moon I really dislike doing. Heaven Trap, and you have to do this twice, too. Which was even more annoying, one to get 80% and one to get 90%. what you have to do is basically follow the line, and it disappears in a while. You have to make, essentially, like, a perfect circle. Study the thing very well, and, pray. Just pray that you get it correctly. See, as you can see there, I cleaned off of there a little bit. I still got more than 80%, which is good, but try imagine getting 100% of this thing. It is horrible. And here I go again, this time doing it 90% this time. I don't even know if I did it correctly or not. I think I might have careened, like, went at the end again. Yeah, I careened a little bit out of the end, but it looks like I was good enough to get 96. But yeah, it took me forever to get through this, by the way. And there's more to walking to the circle thing in Otherworld as well, which is even more annoying. There's a little black dip here I noticed. I thought, oh, maybe there's something underneath there. And lo and behold, there's a moon. Yeah, this game very much rewards a lot of explorations. Like, hey, there's something curious. Let's go see what that is. And it turns out, hey, it actually is something good. It's a moon. So that's something I really like about the game design in this game is that it rewards exploration. It rewards looking out of the boundaries and seeing what the game has to offer. It's like, oh, okay. And I get rewarded for another moon. Yay. granted, moons do become pretty meaningless very late in the game. But you know, that reward of, like, satisfaction is just, I think that's its own reward. Especially since this game just oozes with, like, fun creativity platforming and all that. It's one of the rare 3D platformers that still, like, holds true. Okay, so I finally got those pieces. It definitely is a 3D platformer, so 3D platformers. And that's all I kind of want to say that Super Mario Odyssey might be its best. At least as of now, until, like, another game, like, breaks it. Although, at the same time, I kind of said the same thing with Super Mario Galaxy. Not to say, like, Super Mario Sunshine or 64 is any bad or anything, though I still enjoy those games, especially 64. I won't say not so much with Sunshine, especially if you're playing 100% completing it. But, definitely with beating the game, like, it's certainly worth it. And yeah, Super Mario Odyssey is just also one of those things, although there might be a lot of collecting there. So as you can see right there, I got an acorn nut that was like way away. I skip ahead to going to this area. I actually had to wait a little bit for it to grow, but it turns out I also grew another nut somewhere as well. I forgot exactly where I did that though. I think it was during the playthrough, and then I just never bothered trying to look for it again. But yeah, those nuts are also a reoccurring moon. There's a lot of reoccurring moons that you'll notice whenever you play through the game. Not sure exactly how I got that moon though. I might have stopped and then like ground padded or something, but like, I don't know, my memory's a little bit fuzzy. There's a P thing, and that's the moon I wanted to get originally because I saw as a, oh hey, there's a P. Let me go press it. You didn't really need to, you don't really need to get those, Easter Island sunglasses guys or anything. I just kind of like look it from memory and bam, right there. There it is. More moons to collect with these music notes. Music notes are definitely going to be another motif you'll notice. Lots of the moons, I will say, are pretty recycled, so there may be some repetitiveness towards it. But I think with the way the level's designed, it's not that bad big of a deal. Since the level design certainly makes up for the repetitiveness, so that it gives you like a different experience. There's a lot of posters here, and it took forever for me to collect those posters. I'm speeding this up just for the sake of time. It took me like 5 minutes to get rid of all the posters, I want to say. I don't think that's accurate. It might be a little bit less, but it certainly was a long time, especially since I had a lot of trouble trying to get through certain posters as well, but there we go. There's a map for that. Sorry, not a map. There's a moon for that, and look at that. A lot of moons collected in this world alone. There's certainly a lot of moons in the Sand Kingdom, which is why, like I said, this kingdom in particular goes for a lot more quantity over quality. There's some moons in which I think I certainly appreciate, especially the ones with the warp pipe areas. But yeah, I'm just like, it feels a little very much burnt out if you try to collect as much moon as possible. I don't even think I collected every single moon here possible either. Oh, here, another Koopa cooked moon that I could easily get. Oof. Make sure you drink water every time you do a left play. It really much relaxes your throat whenever you commentate for a long time. I wouldn't necessarily recommend ice because that might ruin the mic quality. Well, not mic quality, but ruin the mic audio. Since you'll be hearing like, a lot of clicking and clanging. But I'm making only an exception for today because it really is a hot day today. Recording this during the summertime is very awful. So I kind of like, whenever it's summer, I usually reserve myself to like, try to edit as much as possible, especially since like I've done a lot of recording recently, so like that's why I had to hire more editors. That's why Ayame is helping me out with certain Let's Plays as well. Not with this one in particular though, but she's helping me with Resident Evil 6, Persona 5, and more games to come in the future, which I will reveal when we get to them. So yeah, during that Koopa the Quick. I like to say it's Koopa the Quick, but technically it's just Koopa free running. I just use the Jaxi. It's the very, very much the easiest way to get from point A to point B. I'm not sure if my route is necessarily the fastest. In fact, I think in terms of speed running, you don't even use the Jaxi at all. You actually use the lightning thing to zoom from your current destination to the town's destination. That honestly is a lot more faster, probably. But Jaxi is a very easy method, especially since the entirety of the Moon Kingdom, or sorry, the Sand Kingdom is basically mostly open world anyway, so it doesn't seem like that's a big of a deal. Oh man, I almost like cut it from the haywire as well, like that Golden Koopa almost snuck behind me. That's close. And it also doesn't help that I have the windows open and I live next to an airport. Not exactly next to an airport, but basically close enough so that you could hear the engines roaring. So yeah, more obstacle challenges. I have some trouble trying to do a wall jump here. But there we go. I would like to stress out that most of these challenges, the timer challenges, I didn't actually do first try. There are multiple times I had to do multiple times. Just because I didn't do them proficiently enough. And I only cut out the parts where I failed, basically. Although there might be some fail moments from time to time, just because I think that might be a little bit funny to do. Another hidden door right here. Yay. Whenever you see coins, by the way, definitely follow them. They give you a lot of hints as to, at least in terms of like a very good game designer perspective. They give you a lot of hints. I'm not sure why I'm doing this blindly. I think I failed in this beforehand. Yeah, I must have failed this beforehand, and so I knew the pathway easily. I got a little dare. Yeah, that's a very poor representation of how I conquered this moon in particular, because I definitely did use the sunglasses guy for the other thing as well. Oh yeah, this Goomba was annoying. I think I only needed one Goomba, but I had like four just in case. And what I did was, like, I used the Goombas all the way from like the entrance of the town to go all the way to the edge of the desert, which was really far away. But yeah. I'm not sure exactly how I discovered this hole, though. I think I wanted to experiment. It's either I wanted to experiment or I accidentally fell into this hole. I was like, oh hey, there's more extra things here. Let's go look for them. Or not. Maybe I missed a moon there, and right now it's just showcasing me getting the, thing. The coins. There's a warp pipe here. These guys are so much fun to play, by the way, especially if you try to glitch out. I'm not sure if it's patched by now, though, but, like, there were glitches in which you could clip through the wall using these guys. And it's a lot of fun to explore out-of-bound territories. Just because. That's something about me I want to say, is that I'm more of like a glitch type of person. Going like above and beyond the usual standard game. Of course, like I do have my limits in terms of like game-breaking glitches and all of that. Those are the type of glitches I absolutely despise. But if it's something like clipping glitches that you can at least escape later on. Oh, I fell there. But yeah, if it's like a glitch in which you escape later on, then I don't mind per se. Because, I always imagine that those are, at the very least, be very useful in terms of speedrunning the game, going out of bounds. I might just be in the minority of this, in fact, I think I am. Because most casual speedrunners, most casual speedrunning viewers don't like glitch speedruns at all. I'm not like that at all. I think that glitches are certainly a fun way to see the flaws within the game program that the developers overlook. And actually using that to their advantage rather than like discrediting the game for that. Like Melee, Super Smash Bros. Melee in particular is very much riddled with glitches and not necessarily bugs, but a lot of exploits. But the Smash community definitely utilizes that to its advantage and makes the game a lot more competitively viable, and I think that's very amazing what they did. Yeah, the Sphinx also makes another return as well. I really like this guy. Gives you a lot of questions, all you have to do is just answer them correctly. You get plenty of chances, so it's not like you go all the way back to the beginning of the first question and have to do it all over again. They are very, very safe when it comes to, showcasing the Sphinx guy. I also like his personality too, it's like, how did you do that? Oh ho ho! It's a lot nicer if you, like, just give him, like, a funny voice as well. Oh yeah, I failed in that question. I assume because, like, it was a pyramid or something, I think there was either 3 or 6, so I thought, oh, it has to be, like, a decibel of 3, right? Because pyramid, duh. But the answer is actually 5, so I just had to, like, guess there. But it did say there used to be 6, so, like, I technically wasn't wrong. Anyways, you got a moon for that one. Okay, I returned back here, I think. I think I, went out of the area without collecting a moon or something else. So that's why I had to go through it twice. Yeah, I think I did forget to collect the moon around here. Ooh. Ooh, that was a close one there. Ow. Okay, that was bad. This is a pro-level gaming right here, ladies and gentlemen. Clearly. Either that or I just want to get to the... Oh, nope, there's a moon there. Okay, so I actually, like... my way through there, hopefully. I'm not sure if I get back to, or if I showcase, the horde coins I got, but literally they were just coins. Alright, went back to this plant right here. Got the moon, got the fake moon, just for extra coins. Like, we're definitely gonna need that later on. I failed trying to dive into it. So I decided to just, oh, fuck it, I'm just gonna jump on it. Although, if I am going on doing, like, HEDQ shit, I'm gonna be very bad at not cursing. Because I'm a cursed little fucker, you know that? And it's kind of hard. Like, I guess I could kind of try to control myself, especially if there's, like, higher stakes. But, like, casually speaking, it's very hard for me to do that. So yeah, going back to the fact that there's, like, 5 Jaxxie statues, I thought, huh, you know what? I'm kind of curious. Let's use the Jaxxie here and collect the moon there. And what you know? There's a moon there. I think also the fact that there was a parrot that helped me out as well, so like that helps. Oh, look at this! I didn't even get a shadow. I don't even see a shadow there, and yet I got the moon. But yeah, I don't like these Lucky 2 missions. At least not as much as all the other ones. Maybe there was a shadow, and just like it's very faint and very opaque. But there was also another one right here. Oh hey, it's Captain Toad. Hello. I think Captain Toad appears in like every level. Could be wrong. He might not have appeared in every level. Oh, speaking of buying another moon, there we go. Like I said, at least buying one of them is a requirement for 100% completionist. Shopping in Tostarina. So that's what the area is for. Oh yeah, there's this dog! Follow it, and then it helps you try to find a moon. Sometimes it doesn't really do much. Sometimes it sees another glowy bit and it just happens to be just more coins or something. Oh yeah, for some reason I didn't even I completely forgot to open up this chest for some stupid reason. I'm an idiot. So I was more focused on like talking to Sphinx that I realized, oh shit, I forgot to go inside. So yeah, there was that. Some more purple points here. Almost a lot so far. And another golden nut there. This one will probably take a while for me to grab, so of course, with every golden nut or golden acorn thing, it certainly requires you or the player to wait a little bit just to get it. So yeah, I did that and threw it all the way there. Of course, I'm saving some travel time, of course. Going back here, I think I went inside there thinking there might have been something. And what'd you know, there is something. Whee. So yeah, like I said, very much rewards exploration. I'm not sure if there was like anything else that I missed around here, or... Nope, this is a different area. This is where we were, I think, close to the boss battle. There's a ledge that I noticed and I was like, oh, I should get use the bullet bill there, and what'd you know it. There it is right here. A secret area. Woohoo! Is that a warp pipe? Or is that just a thing to get another moon? Oh, hello. secret blocks, they always help you out, you know? Oh, oh no! Oh, that was a close one. It's got a very huge fail right there. What the hell am I doing? Oh, I think I'm just going to get more leverage on the thing so I don't have to worry about that much at all. Yeah, okay, so it's a chest. Probably contains a moon. Yep. And I think we're almost close to not getting every single Sand Kingdom moon, but getting all that I've gotten on my own, because these are all the moons I got on my own. And I think the next time we revisit the Sand Kingdom, it's because I had to use a walkthrough. This one took a while because, like, I didn't know, like, the Amiibo and the parrot told me that there's a moon over here, but I can't tell where it is, so I just had to, like, traverse through the entire area. I don't even think I needed a thing at all, but I used it just in case. My goodness, those are a lot of moons. Total of 361 so far, so I am basically 36% of the way of 100% completing it. So yeah, that was,